Welcome to the Murfreesboro Beer Cast, where beer is community and community is a lot more fun with beer. Let's raise a pint, enjoy the show. Cheers.
Hey, my name is Brian Nell. I'm a mortgage loan officer with Primis Mortgage. I want to tell you that I absolutely love being a member of the Spread the Positive Network. It's such a great mission and helps bring so much positivity to our community. It's truly be a pleasure a part of what they do. There are a lot of ways to navigate financing a home, and in markets like this, having the advice of a trusted local professional is key to making sure you get the right advice for your specific circumstances. Whether you're interested in the purchase of a new home, second home, or have a need for a refinance, I'd love to earn your trust. If I can help you nail your mortgage, call me at 615-243-3976 or visit nailyourmortgage.com.
Primis Mortgage is a subsidiary of Primis Bank, a member FDIC, Equal Housing Opportunity. As always, all loans are subject to approval. Primis Mortgage, NMLS number 1894879.
Hello and welcome to the Murfreesboro Beer Cast, your bi-monthly look into what's going on here in Murfreesboro and surrounding areas and all things beer, beer community. Remember that beer is community and community is better with beer. So we're excited to be here today. We've got a fun show in store. We're going to talk about some events that are going on, some new beers that are coming out in some of our, here at Cedar Glade, and then also at some of our colleagues and friends, other breweries as well. We're going to spend just a minute talking about some cool events that are coming up, a.k.a. Shakespeare. We'll talk about that one here in just a little bit. But the highlight of the day, and we've got a homebrewer that we're going to spotlight as well. The highlight of the day, we've got the OG, the original, the man, Mr. Ozzie Nelson, Mr. Mayday, will be in studio with us. And we're going to talk about how he got started and what he loves about this business and what he doesn't love about this business. And I am certain that he will tell us. So we're pretty excited about that. And then we'll wrap it up. So it's going to be a good show. Sit back and listen to what's hopping. All right. First up, we're going to take a look around town to see what's pouring. Take it away, Trent. Awesome. So that's what's pouring here in Murfreesboro. We're going to cut now to a little video and interview with Glenn Thompson of Thompson's Brewed. He is a local home brewer, and you will be able to catch him over at Shakespeare on May 3rd. Super excited about that. Cedar Glade will be there as well. So let's cut to Glenn Thompson.
Zoom in on this. Okay, here's how to get free beer, eh?
So state your name and the name of your brewery.
Glenn Thompson, and the brewery is Thompson's Brewed.
Okay.
You can find us on Instagram, actually. Thompson's, make sure you get the S with Brewed on it.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Gotcha. All right, Thompson's Brewed on Instagram. Mm-hmm. Very good. All right, so how long you been brewing?
Since probably 2016. And then the other part of Thompson's Brewed is my son, who, you know, I taught him how to brew when he was like 18. Strike that. Send him to
brew, not drink.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, we're good.
Send him to Tennessee Tech to be a chemical engineer. So, you know, I could maybe do this, start a brewery someday.
Yeah, you should do it.
And now he stabbed me in the back and he became a distiller. So he works for one of the distilleries in Nashville now. So he's the other part of Thompson's Brewed.
Gotcha. Well, bless his heart, right?
Yeah. Well,
yeah.
So we get access to good barrels.
You know, yeah.
And
yeah,
some other stuff. Yeah.
For sure. What's your favorite kind of beer to brew?
Mainly dark-ish lagers, Doppelbox. This is a Dunkel that we just did.
I tried that. It's delicious. Yeah, very good job.
Thank you.
Yeah. So that's your favorite. What's your favorite to drink? Same thing, or you like something else?
No, pretty much the same thing. Anything I can get from Europe. I'm on this crazy cider kick right now.
Yeah.
You know, I got a bunch of ciders curated for me from a company that imports stuff from all over the world. And I've just been doing a lot of ciders in addition to beer now.
Gotcha. Are you making ciders as well?
I am. So the thing is, in competition, I'm one of the competition guys here too. Mm-hmm. So the guy that ended up beating me for the Mid-South series ended up beating me with cider. And I'm like, so the guy won every medal in every category at the Kentucky State Fair. And I decided, maybe I need to make cider. So I had this company had them curate a bunch of ciders for me from, you know, England and France and whatever. And they sent them in and it like changed my life.
Yeah.
So now I'm like all into cider. So I'm like talking to cider people around Middle Tennessee, orchards. Found there's actually an apple tree from up in Altamont of all crazy places that originated. Everything came from Kazakhstan, but basically there's an North American apple variety that started in Altamont, which is out Warren County, Van Buren County.
Yeah, yeah.
Actually found one of those apple trees, and that's a crazy story how I tried to trace the family down. But I'm supposed to get apples off of that tree to make some cider.
Okay. So truly homegrown then.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
That's awesome. That's awesome. So what is it about home brewing that if somebody's watching this and they've always thought about it, we talked another time to From the Garage guy. You know, a lot of folks start with the Mr. Brew system and kind of stuff. What would you tell somebody that's contemplating getting into home brewing?
It's super easy. I mean, if you can make oatmeal, you can make beer.
He said macaroni and cheese from a box.
Yeah, I mean, if you just make oatmeal and you throw some yeast in it, let it go, and then see what you and you'll make good beer. You will be surprised, right? You'll make beer, and then the next thing you know, it's like anything else. You know, some people have $60,000 bass boats, you know, or whatever, right? I've got a whole brewery in my basement, taking over half of my basement. And my wife just shakes her head,
yeah,
all the time. The next thing you'll be, but I mean, it's like. It's mentally challenging. You know, I kid around all the time. I learned more about chemistry doing brewing than I did at MTSU. Probably shouldn't say that. but, you know, at the time, I didn't care, right?
It's a little more relevant to your life at this point, right?
Absolutely. I know what the end game is, right? I'm trying to make good beer, right? So, yeah.
That's awesome. And what's your favorite event each year that you guys serve at?
And it's kind of a tie. So, Oktoberfest is always a good one. We get a lot of Rutherford County people. Mm-hmm. That's a lot of fun. And then Common John's, their family reunion.
It's awesome, isn't
whatever.
It?
That's a good time.
Yeah,
too.
And it's evolving into something really special.
Yeah. So those Taste of Rutherford's always kind of a fun one, mm-hmm. too. And I don't know, I've got a bunch of Instagram followers from just people that I've met. Actually made a Mexican hot chocolate beer that I've won medals for.
Nice.
And the peppers all came from a guy that I met at the beer festival, and he grows it out here in his backyard in South Murfreesboro.
Fantastic.
And found him, tracked him down. I was like, man, aren't you the pepper guy? And he gave me some chocolate habanero peppers.
Wait, chocolate habaneros?
Chocolate habaneros.
I didn't even know that was a thing.
I didn't either.
That's awesome.
We put it in a Mexican hot chocolate and sent it down to competition, and it did well, won a bunch of medals. And you meet all kinds of interesting people.
Everything.
It's a good time. It's a good time.
For sure. All right, Glenn. Thanks, buddy.
All right. Hey, appreciate it.
Appreciate you.
Awesome. You know, a lot of folks get started in this business through home brewing and that kind of thing, right? And every time I talk to a home brewer, they always say that they started with a Mr. Beer. How did you get started?
I don't think it was Mr. Beer. I think it was, I'm not sure. It was 2 5-gallon buckets.
Two
5-gallon buckets. I did 5-gallon buckets until 2012.
Wow.
When we started doing 1,000 gallons.
Yeah, that's a lot more than two 5-gallon buckets. Hey, this is Ozzie Nelson. If you guys have never had the pleasure of meeting Ozzie, you've missed out, that's for sure. So first of all, let's just get this out there. If you've never met Ozzie, and if you haven't been to Mayday, you need to fix that this week.
For sure.
Not next week, you know, this week. So Mayday, if you love craft beer in Murfreesboro, you are remiss to not acknowledge what you guys have contributed to that scene, that community right here. So whether you're a home brewer, you're a craft beer lover, whatever, I mean, you guys are the OGs here in town.
Thanks, Jonathan. That was flattering. This is the week to come to May Day because it's Disney week. Nice. So we'll have Disney.
Tell me more about this.
We have Disney, well, tonight, which you won't see it tonight, but tonight we'll have Disney. Tomorrow night, Tuesday night, we'll have Disney music bingo. Wednesday, we'll have 2-for-1s. That doesn't count for
Well, if I had Disney. To go to Disney, I'd need 2-for-1s.
But Disney, exactly. Thursday, we'll be dress up for Disney and come to bingo, so it'll be Disney bingo. Friday is Disney karaoke. And then Saturday, we have Mize in the Drive for 420. So we have live music on Saturday night, but no Disney theme there.
Okay, well,
but throughout until Friday, it's all Disney.
You
all
might
the
be
time
able to get them
it.
To play a Disney song. Guys in the Driver, some princes for sure. They could play Let It Go.
They probably could, but I won't ask them.
So, what in the world possessed you guys to do Disney Week? Where did that come from?
We had Disney Day, and then it kind of morphed into, okay, how can we do this more of an adult thing? So yeah. We've kind of, because adults buy beer.
Yes, that's true. Kids don't, I hope. They don't here anyway.
Kids don't buy beer at my brewery, but they come. They're welcome.
Right.
But so we're doing this as an experiment. This is the first time we've done it Disney Week. So it's Disney theme every night.
That's pretty cool, week. Man. That's fun. All right, so I'm going to start with some questions. And I prepped him all of about 5 minutes ago with these questions. So
you better
be on it, buddy. What's the weirdest thing you've ever, and I want to be real specific about this, brewed into a beer, not just put in a beer?
I can't think of anything that weird that we've actually put in a beer. But I can talk a little bit about beer and what you put in a beer versus how beer sells.
Okay.
We had a beer once. What did we call that beer? I can't even remember what we called it. It didn't sell for nothing. It was high gravity. It was a stout. It was a double. It was high gravity. And nobody bought it.
What was in it?
It was just this big, heavy stout.
It
was a first run. We only used the first runnings. We didn't rinse the grains, so it was high gravity.
Yeah, yeah.
And we didn't make a whole lot of it, but it did not sell. And then we called it, what did we call it? What's his name? Didn't stout himself.
Epstein.
Epstein.
I remember that.
Epstein
yeah, yeah.
Didn't stout himself. Once we renamed that beer to Epstein Didn't Stout Himself,
it was gone.
Everybody wanted that beer.
Isn't that funny?
The old name. Nobody wanted it. Could not sell it for anything. It was a crappy name for sure, but it was.
Did people just want Epstein didn't stout himself on their Untappd or what?
We just put that out there. Everybody wanted the Epstein, and it got us through COVID. I mean, we sold so many high dollar crowlers for that beer because it was so high gravity. You had to charge more.
Yeah, yeah.
So we that got us through COVID. Epstein didn't stout himself.
I remember when that came out. I'm like, oh. Yeah, they did. Yep, they sure did.
That's so funny. I don't know about things that we put in a beer, but it's kind of weird how beer sells and based on just the name or the image that's on the can.
So y'all don't do like chili peppers and cakes and donuts and odd fruit, lychees or anything like that?
Trying to think. We've put peppers in beer before, but that's not really weird. A lot of people do that. We had Buck Jaw, which is Tim and Christy Miller. They brewed at the brewery a few weeks ago and had a pepper beer that was good. So
yeah.
It was kind of a mild pepper flavor, but not a lot of burn.
Right, right.
A little burn on the back end, but I've had pepper beers before that were...
Whew. Oh, me too. I had a ghost pepper beer one night it was at the end of the night at Shakespeare about 6 years ago. And I thought I was going to die. I mean, I was sweating. It was bad. Oh, it was so bad.
I'm not sure if I want to make that experience for somebody.
You don't. It's terrible. That's a lot of homebrewers there. And so they just said, hey, why not? Because
for sure.
They don't have to worry about selling it,
yeah.
right?
When you have to worry about selling it, it's a whole different ballgame.
No doubt. No doubt about it. All right. So your opinion, does glitter belong in beer?
Oh, yeah, we have a glitter beer right now. It's called Pixie Dust, damn it. Pixie Dust for the Disney Week.
Oh, okay. Pixie Dust. Got it. Got it.
So we do
Mommy,
have,
can I have a drink of your
we
glitter
We have
drink?
A glitter beer for sure. Right now it's blue glitter, not green, but it is what it is.
That's hilarious.
We do have that on tap right now. So you can get that tomorrow.
So how long, and I know you guys do a great job of keeping everything clean and all of that kind of stuff, but does the glitter linger in the beer lines?
I think not really in the beer lines, but when we clean the kegs, you can definitely tell in the bottom of the keg cleaner there's glitter, and you try to do the glitter to keg last.
Yeah, yeah.
So that every other keg doesn't accidentally have a little hint
cross-contaminate
of
a granule of glitter
exactly
everywhere. Yeah. What's your favorite style of beer to drink?
I like pale ales more than anything, I think. I like pale ales a lot.
Yeah.
So it's not too much hops, but give me some caramel malt and some Cascade hops, old school.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's what I
keep it simple.
That's my favorite style of beer to drink.
I like it. Now, does your on the brewing side of things, does it differ? Is there something that you love to brew more than you like to drink necessarily?
Brewing's all the same. It's to me.
Okay.
Actually, Kelsey brews all the beer, so that's my daughter. She brews all the beer at Mayday.
Hey,
so
she does a hell of a job.
She does a great job, and it's all the same. It's just one beer that is when we're milling in the redhead is kind of a pain, and because it's so many different grains that you have to get together to get the color right, so it's a little bit of a pain. But the Inner Sanctum has so many bags of grain. That one's the one you really don't want to mill in for.
Yeah, that thing's a meal, dude.
Yeah, 47 bags of 55-pound bags of grain for that beer, and it's working this summer.
What do you guys do with your spent grain?
We give it to two different farmers. One has chickens, and he puts it on his field, and another has some beef cattle. We had a dairy cattle farmer take our grain for years, and he stopped about this year, maybe the end of last year. So
we have a beef cattle farmer that takes ours as well, and it's funny, it you know, small, much smaller batches than what you guys do at a time, and he loads the IBC tote on the back of his gator, and he said the cows at this point are trained or have trained themselves, I guess they follow him out to where he dumps the grain. They know what's coming. It's pretty awesome.
Yeah, we don't get that intimate with the farmer, but he does. He has sent us a video of the cows eating the grain, so that was fun.
That's awesome. Now, you guys do a ton of different events at your place. Some of them are a little more tame than others. What is of the events that you guys put on, what's your favorite one each year?
It's got to be Hot Chicken.
In my head, I'm like, I don't know why I'm asking this question, but...
And it's usually the third week of August, and it's hot, and it's a redneck party. It's all a lot of fun. It always rains. You know, there's always that afternoon downpour. Yeah. So
it's 900 million degrees because of the steam.
And it's humid, yes. You wear your best redneck outfit, show a little pocket with your shorts, and we crown king and queen of the trailer park, have live music all day, and it's a lot of fun.
Now, was it last year or the year before you started rerunning some of your old videos?
Oh, yeah, we did that. We did do that last year, some old promo videos, right? Those were good.
They were awesome. They were awesome.
I could do that again this year. We have enough old promo videos for sure.
Now, your role from when you guys got started has evolved. You just mentioned that Kelsey's doing your brewing and such. So tell me how that's evolved. Tell me how you got started and what you were doing, and then how that's evolved to now.
When we got started, I hired a brewer from Chicago. So he came down and brewed for about 2 years, and then I had various different brewers brew until Kelsey started. She graduated from Murray State University in Kentucky with a biology degree, and she said I wanted to come work at the brewery. So she started working at the brewery doing the back office work, and then she just made her way to the brewery. So that was kind of the evolution. She's been there, I don't want to lie, I think 7 years. Yeah. 7 years, maybe 8 years.
Well,
7 or 8 years.
Some of the funniest things that I've witnessed at my tap room is every now and then she'll come visit. You know, we'll go visit you guys. You come visit over here or whatever. And her and Robert will sit there, and that is the nerdiest conversation.
Oh, she can be nerdy.
Oh, my word. Yeah. It gets above my head real fast.
I don't participate in that.
Yeah.
I'd rather just talk about life than talk about how to lower your pH or whatever you're trying to do.
I hear that. So why did you start Mayday?
I think for me, I have a full-time job in corporate America. I've had that full-time job now for 38 years.
Good gracious. You're old.
I am old. 38 years in corporate America. And the legacy is not what of dying working at corporate America is not what I wanted. I wanted to do something else where people knew me for something.
Sure.
And so, and that's kind of why I started Mayday. Not for my love of beer, although I love beer, to have some place in the community that I could say I did something.
Yeah.
That was apart from corporate America, that wasn't under their, you know,
there's satisfaction in the creation, right? And so whether that's the concept of the place and then creating it,
for
and
sure,
it, and it coming into what you envisioned, there's also satisfaction in the evolution of that, right? And watching, it's like watching your kid grow up.
It is that. Sometimes painful. Sometimes your kids disappoint you.
Serve you that know, one up. I love you, Kelsey, you know, but I serve that one up there.
You know, you think this is what they're going to be like, and then they turn out to be something. You know, something happens, you know.
Sure.
It's cool to have my face on a beer can.
Yeah.
That's, you know, I can die happy. I have my face on a beer can.
That's pretty cool. Now, you are known to give the best brewery tours. I'm going to go ahead and say probably in the mid-state for sure.
Tell me, I give the best brewery tour. I don't care where you go.
Tell me about your brewery tour and what makes the Aussie brewery tour better than everybody else's.
Well, right now, I only give brewery tours by appointment. So you have to set up an appointment, have 10 people.
He's in demand like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Actually, no. But I had one this Saturday. Well, the first thing I do is make sure I know everybody's name. If there's 50 people on a tour, I know everybody's name on that tour. I don't know anybody else that gives a tour that know everybody's name
on the tour. I've never seen that, yeah.
I know everybody's name on the tour. I talk to everybody. I mention everybody's name on the tour. We go back and forth. It's a conversation. But I also get my points across, and it's lively. I don't stand and tell you the technical stuff. I move. We're moving. We're going. I'm moving from tank to tank to kind of give you an idea of what's in that tank, and I have different ways of expressing that so that it's always, everybody knows. If you've seen my tour, you know, water. You know that.
And so, I have not personally been on one of these tours, so I don't know that. I think we got to make this happen.
So I make it fun. I know everybody's name. We go back and forth. I give you hell. You can give me hell too. I have snacks on the tour. We drink a lot of beer and have a good time. Make now, friends.
Is there something about a cart?
We have
something?
A chair. We used to call it the Twitter chariot because I would give someone my phone and they would live tweet the tour. I quit doing that when people started texting my landlord. from my phone. God. That was uncool.
Yeah.
So I stopped doing that, but they still ride in the chair. One person, one lucky person rides in the chair and everybody else follows them. And that's kind of the person with the award. I don't know, the coolest person or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
I just say, you birthday girl, you're in the chair.
That's funny. I love it. All right, so we're going to taste some beer here in a second.
Yeah.
And I full disclosure, I cheated. I didn't mean to. It was an accident. We haven't actually done a blind test yet. And so this time we were supposed to, and Ozzy brought them in koozies, and I peeked. What can I say?
You peeked for one. You don't know what the other one is.
Just one. That's right. I have no idea. And look, I don't know what they are. Real quick, some coming soons. Cedar Glades got the El Cedro, the Mexican lager. You guys have some other coming soons as well. Buckjaw is doing another beer with you guys. You're releasing it soon.
It's a Doppelbach. I don't remember what they're calling it. Currently, we have their steam beer on tap.
I love steam beers.
It's so smooth. It's really good.
Mm-hmm.
They do a great job. And then the Jam IM.
Yeah, tell me about that.
It's going to be on tap for a while. It's the it's our blackberry sour. So it's going to be on tap for the summer. It's good blackberry sour, solid beer. We also have the Stones River Lager is back. That was out for a couple of weeks. It's back and rolling again.
It's great beer. So. And I've had that at the beer garden at MTSU before.
Yeah. That's been out there for sure.
Yeah, for sure. All right, so we got a couple glasses over there if you'll grab those. Yeah. I don't even know how to properly operate a blind taste, so...
Well,
I'm not going to peek. You go ahead.
I was going to pour one. Well, you already looked at it.
Does it help if I don't remember what it was?
And then pour the other one. You don't remember?
I really don't remember.
I don't know how you could have seen it so fast for as fast as you were looking, but I don't know how much of this I'm supposed to pour either.
Oh, this is perfect.
This is my favorite beer right now that we serve. It's a beautiful beer. I love it. I drink it.
Cheers.
Not all the time, but every time I'm at the brewery, I'm drinking this beer.
Mm. I love the nose.
It's so... Oh, shoot. This is wrong. I skipped the beer. This is the second beer.
Oh, I really don't know what this is.
You have
probably.
No idea what this beer is unless you guess. Unless you guess. After I tasted it. Oh, yeah, it does have a nose, doesn't it? Oh, shoot, that's the wrong beer. It was blind taste test.
So, it tastes like a stout to me.
But the hops.
Mm-hmm.
There's lots of hops.
A lot more bitey.
Yeah.
Black IPA?
Yeah, it's the evil octopus.
Mm. Yes, it is.
It's the evil octopus. Yes, it is. Tattoo on my back. My two dirt girls fighting the evil octopus. One's on a horse. You get to see that if you go on the tattoo. If you go on the tour. The tattoo. If you go on the tour, the evil octopus gets revealed.
That's delicious. Yeah. I've had this beer, but it's been quite a while.
Well, we just re-released it a couple of months ago. Mm-hmm. So
yeah, it's
good.
A little bit of
difference in the hops. Dry hopped it really good.
Well, I like the hops because they're fulfilling in it. That, like, I can kind of have that feeling in the back of the throat, you know?
Oh, yeah.
But they're not, they don't linger around for a long, long time. You know, they're not unpleasant
it's
at
not
all.
Crazy it's crazy bitter or anything
no,
like
it's
that.
Extremely well balanced, but there's enough roastiness on top of
that. Oh, there is. Yeah, it's really hard to make a beer that where the hops come through and the roast comes through. Mm-hmm. The roast usually overtakes those hops.
Mm-hmm.
And in this
sweetens
beer...
it, but in a weird way a lot of times. Yeah.
It, especially as it ages, the hops fade.
Yeah. I like this,
this
man.
One,
this is good.
It's nice beer.
So it's been so long since I've had it. One of my favorite beers that you guys ever made was Soul.
Oh, yeah, Dark Lager.
Oh, man, that was such a good beer.
I think we're coming back with that probably this fall.
Mm. Noted. We need to put that on my calendar. If we can find out what date that is, I'll be there.
Well, we haven't gotten a date yet. We're
all right.
Not that cool.
Evil Octopus.
We haven't gotten a date yet. Yeah,
excellent
that's the
choice.
Evil Octopus. This is the beer that I drink. I drink a lot of the Evil Octopus too.
I can see that. That's a meal beer to me. Like drink that with a steak.
Oh,
or something.
Yeah, for sure. Mm-hmm. It pairs really well. This is the beer that I drink the most of. I drink this beer every time I'm at the brewery. This is my favorite beer.
So interestingly, and if you use these lights, this one's not as dark
as
what we just drank. It's almost got a very deep red color to it, which is it's stunningly beautiful, actually. I mean, look at that color.
Yeah, it's nice.
Don't make fun. It is stunningly beautiful.
I wanted to have this one first because that the Evil Octopus, there's so many flavors it almost overwhelms you. This one is more of a drinking beer.
That's
you can
stout.
Pound this beer. This is the Tale of the Dragon Porter.
Porter, okay.
So it's the
light.
easiest drinking porter I've ever drank. Usually porter's a little bit heavy on you. This beer is just you can chug this beer.
Yeah. What's the ABV on this? About 5.5?
I think it's about 5.5. It should say on the bottom of that can. 5.5. The Evil Octopus is 6.3, I think.
Which is still not. A lot of IPAs hitting the sevens pretty quick. That's so. You can still drink several of those. Is my point.
Oh yeah, the
you start getting
Octopus,
up
sure.
into the seven
yeah,
and a half.
Yeah, you're drinking that a little bit slower because it's a more in your face beer.
Yeah, this is good.
This I just drink it.
I don't think I've ever had this, Ozzy.
We've had it.
You've had it for a while.
Yeah, we've had it a little while.
Because I typically shy away from the porters for exactly the reason that you were just talking about it. I kind of. Swells up your belly.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
This is more of a...
I don't need any more
almost,
belly swelling than I got.
Almost like Bud Light.
It's a lot more flavorful
easy,
than that.
Easy to drink like that. It doesn't fill you up. It's just nice.
Yeah, and I absolutely love the color.
I recommend this to people that whether they like dark beer or not, just close your eyes and drink this beer. It's fine.
Have you encountered folks, and we see this all the time, where they're like, oh, I don't like dark beer. It's too strong for me. And usually I'm like, let's talk about what you mean by strong, right? Because oftentimes the darker beer doesn't have as high of an ABV, and it certainly doesn't have as strong of a hop presence. And so, I mean, for me, the first beers, when I started getting into beer when I was not of age, the first beers I was really drinking that I liked were the darker beers.
Yeah, I had the same experience. When I started craft beer, I started with the dark beer. But I think the hops, too bitter. You know, mm-hmm. I was afraid of the bitter.
Yeah.
But now people say a lot, what do you have that's light? When you talk about light color, you may not want to talk about light.
That's right.
Because light's not light. When you talk about the Inner Sanctum, it's probably the lightest color beer that we have. But it ain't light.
It isn't light.
It's got 47 bags of grain in there.
Right.
And a whole bunch of hops.
Yeah.
It's well, 7.6%, 7.7%.
And probably extremely hoppy. Yeah.
It's bitter.
Well, I mean, you look at.
But it's light.
A strong golden beer, a Belgian strong or a Belgian
sure,
golden.
Yeah.
I mean, some of those are hitting 10, 11, 12%.
Oh, yeah, you're up there.
And it looks like in the glass, it looks like a Bud Light. And then you take a drink of it and you go, oh.
Oh, and then you got a buzz. All
right. Yeah, right, exactly, from smelling it. But anyway, this is excellent. Good choice.
I thought I'd bring two dark beers so that you'd have two beers that were different, but different.
They look the same.
They look the same. They look the same. Or,
yeah, close. Yeah.
But it's not really dark beer season right now. However, you can still drink dark beer
I'm going to take umbrage with that. That whole like dark beer season thing, like you drink dark beer in the winter. I think that's BS, man.
I think people do it. I don't care whether you have that opinion or not. People just do it.
Yeah, that's a fair point. But still, like
this beer right here, I drink it.
Yeah.
All year round.
Your porter, we have the pecan
Evil
porter.
Evil Octopus 2 is another beer that I mean, if you want an IBA, if you want a dark hoppy beer,
yeah,
or a hoppy beer in general, it's a nice switch up from your hazies.
It is.
Cuz hazies are getting everybody's got five hazies.
And yeah, and then they just keep getting crazier and crazier, and I don't know, man. Sometimes I just want a beer that tastes like a beer.
Yeah, the mosaics, mosaic hops are not your thing.
Not
my favorite.
No, I get that.
I mean, I have my faces on the can, but it's not my favorite beer.
Touché. Well,
but I'll drink it.
Disney week this week over at Mayday.
Disney week, yes, sir.
Dress up like a princess.
I'll be a pirate.
You'll be a pirate.
I'll be a pirate tomorrow night.
I think you could pull that off. And other than that, what else you guys got coming up in the, like, out a little bit?
We have Mayday. That's a Wednesday, May 1st. We'll have live music. It's Wednesday, so we'll have 2-for-1 plus live music. So it'll be a good time. Mayday. Cinco de Mayday, which is May the 5th,
I'm noticing
which is a Sunday.
Here. Yeah.
We love May and Mayday. May the 5th, which is Sunday. We'll have live music on that day, and we'll have a Mexican food truck. Further out, 21st of April, we have a vendor fair. So that's a Saturday, April 21st, vendor fair. That'll be a lot of fun.
So
lots of different
vendors. Is this like a craft fair type?
Craft vendor fair, yeah, sure. Huh? Then it's the 20th.
I'm pretty sure it's on our slide.
Good.
Yes.
Good.
That's out there, for sure. It'll be a lot of fun
this week. I told y'all, never a dull moment with Ozzy Nelson. Yeah, it's great.
Yeah.
All right, buddy.
That just puts work on my, you know. Okay, I've got to do this, and this.
Plan it all out, and then it's like, oh, it's go time.
Oh shoot! Yeah. If it's the 20th, yeah, you're right about that. Way to go, Missy.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, again, if you haven't been to Mayday, definitely go check them out. What's the address?
It's 521 Old Salem Road.
Okay. Back behind Clark Metal and all of that stuff.
Don't go that way because you'll get stuck by the train. Just go Kings Highway.
Oh, I'll go that way. I don't mind getting stuck by the train.
No. You may be sitting there a while. No, you know what day it is, Jonathan.
Yeah. Well, sometimes I make a U-turn and then go around bridge.
There's a whole bunch of ways to get to Mayday Brewery. Just type in Mayday Brewery in in your favorite GPS app.
Are you a Waze or a Google
I'm a
Maps
Waze or... guy for sure.
I'm a Waze guy too. My wife makes fun of me all the time.
I live on Waze.
I like the little sword dude, you know? It's like a video game with the Wazers around and stuff. Anyway.
Yeah, for sure. There's that. I Waze.
All right.
That's the only app I know.
Waze. Very good. Ozzie Nelson, Mayday Brewery. This is year 11, right?
12.
12.
Going on 12.
Man.
Going on 12 years.
This is the guy right here. All right. You guys go check him out. Dress up like a princess or a pirate or whatever. And that'll be good.
Sounds good.
I'm going to dress up like a bald guy.
You'd pass.
Thanks a bunch, man. All right, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ozzie Nelson. Golly, that guy. I'm not going to lie, man. I'm a little bit tired now. He's a hoot. So, again, Mayday, the OGs, if you guys haven't been out there yet, definitely make sure, you make it out there and check it out. So appreciate him coming in. We're going to start now and, roll, all the events that are coming up here in Murfreesboro at all of our, different colleagues' places of beardom. All right, this concludes this episode of the Murfreesboro Beercast. Thank you for watching. And if you didn't watch, thanks for nothing. And we appreciate everybody that helps make beer community. And remember that community is better with a beer. We'll talk to you again real soon. Thanks for listening. Thank you to our guest and to our fine, fine sponsor, Mr. Brian Nail over at Premise Mortgage. Please go out and support your local brewers.